News review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we show you how to use the language from the latest news stories in your everyday English. Hi, I'm Neil, and joining me today is Catherine. Hi, Catherine.
Hello, Neil. Hello, everybody.
So what's our story?
Well, today's story is about an Olympian rescue.
An Olympian rescue. That sounds fascinating. Let's find out some more from this BBC Newsbeat report.
In Italy, an Olympic swimmer saved a man from drowning on his honeymoon off the coast of Sardinia. Filippo Magnini, who's an ex-world champ, jumped into the sea after people shouted to sunbathers for help.
So, a man was on his holidays. It was actually his honeymoon in Sardinia. He was in the sea on an inflatable unicorn, of all things. He got into trouble. He shouted. And luckily for him, there was an Olympian swimmer. His name was Filippo Magnini. And he swam out and rescued this guy. So, it was a very lucky day for our honeymooner.
It was indeed. And you have been looking at the headlines for this story. And what have you found?
I have found stroke of luck, newlywed and goer.
OK, stroke of luck, newlywed and goer. Stroke of luck. Can we hear that in a headline, please?
We can. So we will look at the mail online. The headline is stroke of luck. Drowning man is rescued by world champion swimmer who was holidaying on the same beach with his wife.
That is a stroke of luck. Lucky event which helps you achieve something. That's the definition.
Yes. So stroke, S-T-R-O-K-E, is a verb with multiple meanings. And can also be a noun. So it's got lots of different meanings. You can often, you can first of all stroke a cat.
So that makes contact in an affectionate way.
You run your hand over its fur, or you can stroke somebody's hair. It's a lovely, pleasurable feeling for everybody concerned. Yes, and it's a verb of movement and touch.
Yeah.
You can also stroke as a movement and touch, which is very, very negative. It can be actually to hit somebody. So if I get a big stick and I hit you 10 times, I will give you 10 strokes of my cane.
Which happened yesterday. Didn't.
Also stroke, it can be, there's actually a swimming meaning. Mm-hmm. Again, a verb of movement. The way you move your body when you swim is described as a stroke. So you can have breast stroke on your front. You can have back stroke where you lie on your back with your arms going. So it's a verb of swimming movement. And it also can be, in this phrase, stroke of luck, actually just means a piece of luck, a lucky event, something unexpected, which is good. Mm-hmm. Happens to you, you don't expect it, it's really good. You've had, and the verb is to have, a stroke of luck.
And in this headline, we've got two meanings going on here, haven't we?
Well, yes, it's the swimming-related meaning. It really means a piece of luck, but this the headliners love to play with words, and the fact that swimming is also related to the word stroke makes it an irresistible headline, yes.
Yeah. And we say piece of luck and bit of luck as well.
Yes, we do, yes. And I would love to know about your last stroke of luck.
Well, yeah. I had an incredible stroke of luck the other day. I was on a bike ride with Rob. And
that was lucky in itself?
That was a stroke of luck in itself. Going down the Thames River, and Rob went miles ahead of me because he quite likes to ride fast, let's say. I saw this blue piece of paper on the ground and I stopped and I thought, what's that? I picked it up. It's a £5 note.
Wow.
That's a stroke of luck.
What a stroke of luck.
And I thought, I'll put that in my pocket. Because if Rob finds out, you know what he'll want.
Biscuits.
He'll want biscuits. Yeah, so I kept that to myself.
You rotten thing. You know what they say, if you don't share luck, you lose it.
Well, I'll look forward to that.
Cancel out your luck.
OK, on to our next headline, please.
OK, we'll look at BBC News. Filippo Magnini, Italian Olympic swimming star, saves drowning newlywed.
Newlywed, a person who has recently married.
Yes.
That's pretty easy and straightforward.
Very obvious meaning, but it's a very interesting way of putting these two parts of the words together. The second part, wed, comes from wedding. It's also a verb to wed somebody. We add newly, N-E-W-L-Y, and you put them all together to get newlywed. You can, when we have newlywed, we often use it with a or the. So you can say, I am a newlywed. I got married 3 weeks ago. You can talk about the newlyweds. Mm-hmm. Two people who are married, a married couple, are the newlyweds.
Yeah.
You're only a newlywed for a short amount of time.
Yeah, doesn't last beyond your first anniversary.
Probably not, no. Sometimes you see it with a hyphen, newly hyphen wed. Sometimes there's one word, newlywed, more often like that. We don't see it as two separate words.
No. And it's a shame about this word, really, because it's so simple. You'd like to apply this kind of rule elsewhere.
Yeah.
It doesn't work, does it? You can't say the newly born.
Or the newly dead.
Or the newly graduated.
Or the newly promoted.
No.
Yeah, it doesn't work. For babies, we can say the newborn baby, mm-hmm. but we don't use the L-Y.
Yeah.
So really, newlywed is really just for people who've recently got married.
Okay.
So congratulations, all newlyweds everywhere.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Now, as fans of News Review, you are no doubt learners of English and you have many, many questions. And we've got a stroke of luck for them, haven't we?
Yes.
Because there is a series just for you called Learners Questions. What can you tell them about that?
Learners Questions, if you click on the link down here, we'll send you straight to the playlist. You'll see Dan answering your questions. If you want to send us a question, please do. And you may have a stroke of luck and find that Dan answers your question just for you.
And on to our final headline, please, Catherine.
The Straits Times. Beachgoer who fell off inflatable unicorn in Sardinia rescued by Italian Olympic swimmer.
Goer, person who regularly goes to a place.
Exactly that. Now, goer isn't a word in this sense. We don't use it alone. It's always on the end of a noun. So we take a noun, beach, we add goer, and it basically means a person who goes to the beach.
Regularly.
Regularly, yes, regularly. We can use this for other activities. We can use other nouns. Theatre goer, film goer, opera goer, church goer.
Football goer?
No, not football goer, unfortunately.
So what's the difference then?
Well, it's about sort of spiritual or cultural activities that you do for often enjoyment, pleasure or, you know, good high reasons.
To improve yourself.
To improve yourself, yes. Now, you may argue that going to watch football also improves yourself. Unfortunately, it doesn't work like this in this sense. So you're not really for sport. We don't say football goer, rugby goer. It's cinema goer, film goer, opera goer, activities like that.
Now time for a recap of our vocabulary, please.
Okay, so we had stroke of luck, lucky event which helps you achieve something. Newlywed, person who is recently married. Goer, person who regularly goes to a place.
If you'd like to test yourself on the vocabulary in this programme, there's a quiz you can take on our website at bbclearningenglish.com where you can find all kinds of other videos and activities to help you improve your English. And of course, we have a free app as well. Thank you for joining us and goodbye.
Goodbye.
News Review from BBC Learning English.
Hi everyone, we hope you enjoyed that video and thank you very much for watching. We have so many more just like it, so if you don't want to miss a single one, make sure to subscribe and we will see you regularly. Hope to see you soon. Bye guys.